okay, this is Uncharted Drake's Fortune Part 6. I think it might be the last part. We might be able to squeeze the last two chapters in this. So let's get started right away. I just fought a bunch of, well, I don't know what they were, but I didn't enjoy fighting them. This one is called Race to the Rescue, so we're probably going to be driving again. But man, is this game shorter than I anticipated. Oh, that's Sully. My bad. I feel like he wasn't in this game much. I assume they fix that glitch, if it is a glitch, in the next game, because it's really weird to have them go flying like that. Alright, where are we going now? What? How many shots is that guy gonna take? The gunplay is not good in this. I suspect the sequel is going to be like, because it seems to be the case where, unlike with movies, with games, you have the first one was like pretty good, and then the second one is vastly superior. Like they learned a lot of lessons from the first one. Like Gears 2 is so much better than Gears 1. Oh, crap. Move! Oh my gosh. Too clunky for this many enemies. Gears 2 was like way better than Gears 1. Halo 2 is way better than Halo 1. Depending on who you ask, Mass Effect 2 is better than 1. It's just based on opinion, though. The gameplay was definitely better. Oh my gosh, I hate these stupid grenade launchers everywhere. At this point, I'd rather fight the stupid monsters. How many more of there are you? Jeez. What other game sequels are better than the original? Evil Within 2. I've heard Dishonored 2, even though Dishonored 1 is fantastic, 2 is better. But I'm looking for examples where, like, it's substantially better.
You gotta stop them, Sully. They don't know what they're dealing with.
What are you...
I don't know how, but that statue destroyed the whole colony. And it killed the Germans, too.
Whoa, come again?
There's no time. We've gotta get to the church.
Yeah, where's the church? Is it this way? This would be so much better with if gameplay wasn't archaic. Oh, another one. Assassin's Creed 2 is way better than Assassin's Creed 1. Out of here with your grenade launchers. Another example is Saints Row 2 compared to Saints Row 1. It's almost like a universal rule where the sequel is better. BioShock 2, I think the story was better in 1, but the gameplay is better in 2. That's usually what happens, is at the very least the gameplay is better in the sequel. Now, one that's tough is, I think, Dead Space it's hard to say whether or not 2 is better than 1. It's more, slightly more action. I keep running out of ammo, and there's so many freaking enemies. It really didn't give you enough in this game, at all. How do they expect me to finish this with the pitiful amount of ammo they give me? So many lasers. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay, thank God. I thought I had to do all that again. Please go away. Game.
Come on, Sully. There should be a hidden passage right under the altar.
Last Crusade. Whoa. 21 golden bones.
You want to tell me what the hell's going on? Drake didn't want to get the treasure off the island, Sully. He was trying to stop it from leaving.
What?
It's cursed or something.
Oh, Nate, for God's sake.
Look, I know it sounds crazy. You just gotta trust me.
Are these the catacombs? It's reminding me of Wolfenstein, the Old Blood.
Oh, man.
What?
You two should realize by now that I plan for every contingency. Now drop your weapon. Down there. No heroics, please. Or I will kill her. Good. Now, if you'll just hang tight, we'll be with you in a moment. It's magnificent. The craftsmanship. I've never seen anything like it before.
That is only a shell.
Wait, what's
the
in it?
The real treasure of El Dorado lies inside.
Is it an alien? Because aliens built the pyramids and aliens are... I don't know.
My God.
What? What?
Watch this.
Is this the final boss? Well, it still says 21, so. Okay. Wait, so how do I prevent that from happening? Too bad I can't really enjoy the sound effects and music that much because it's playing from my TV. I don't have a choice though if I'm gonna capture it. See, in the later games, you would be, like, playing this part. It wouldn't be a cutscene. They just didn't have the tech yet. Oh, this is the end. Showdown. I can tell it's gonna be fun. I need something other than a shotgun. Okay, I just show my face for a second and die. This is why I need something else other than a shotgun. How am I supposed to do this if they destroy my cover? And I have a shotgun and the range is awful on it. Done with this game so I can move on to a game that has better gameplay. This is jank. This is kind of a lame final fight, it's on a boat. Well, this was a new IP at the time, so they probably didn't have a huge budget. I'm sure the budget increased a lot on the second one. So irritating. Can't even show your face without dying here. Really? This sucks. This is a terrible final mission. This is not good game design. It wouldn't be so bad if they gave me something other than a shotgun. Howard runs when all of his guards are gone. This is such a stupid final boss. Literally can't show your face and you die. Bravo. Bravo, Naughty Dog. Round of applause for such brilliant design. Thank God I don't care about trophies, because it'd be a pain trying to beat this game on the hardest difficulty. This next part, I just don't have enough ammo. I don't have any ammo. What do you want me to do? There's literally, like, I don't understand how you're supposed to do this. And then when you fail, you have to start from back here. This is awful. This is a terrible final boss. I'm just gonna time it so I do it when he's not shooting. Get up! Get up! You idiot! The non-responsiveness of this game is gonna get me killed. I hate you, Naughty Dog. Why would you make this as the final boss? This is the stupidest. I don't even know the last time I played something this poorly designed. It's just unfair. It's not like tough but fair. It's like they just make it for you. Oh, you have very little ammo. You have a shotgun. You insta kill. This is poo poo. Thought this game was supposed to be amazing. This ending brings it down a lot. Get into cover, you idiot! Don't worry! Oh my god. Get, you idiot! This... Did you see that? I lost because Nate wouldn't get into cover. It was a one-hit kill and he's like, I can't get into cover. Well, now I know why this game takes most people 8 hours to beat. The last hour, or the last 2 hours, is the freaking stupidly designed boss fight. Almost like it's made like this to pad out the runtime. Oh, this is hell. I tried to get into cover, I almost had it. And Nate was being a moron. Get into cover! Get into cover, you moron! Man, the cover system's awful. You roll. This is terrible. No! Oh, no! What? I am... I had one left. This is... Oh my gosh. You don't get enough ammo! I'm just gonna rage. The rest of this video is gonna be me raging. This is stupid. Gosh, you moron! This, and you know what? It might be too early to call, but this might be the worst final boss I've ever played in a game. This is terrible. Not because it's like, I mean, there's bad ones out there, but it's because they're stupid or they're like weird. Well, this is just poorly designed. Doesn't like it's, the way it functions is stupid. I may not even finish this today because of this crap. This might be an hour of me ramming my head against the wall. They seriously don't give me enough ammo, and it's insane. You couldn't pay me to do this on the hardest difficulty. And I'm out of ammo. No! This is idiotic! This is stupid. You know what? Screw this. Where's YouTube? Where's YouTube? I don't even care. I'm just gonna watch the ending. I'm not going to subject myself to that crap. I'm just going to watch this and then play two. Screw that. This is going to work. Listen to that thing. Man, Japan, I thought you were better than this, right? Why can't you make a quiet console, but Xbox can? Okay, YouTube takes a million years to load on PlayStation, and it does it, like, in 3 seconds on Xbox. I'm gonna have to insert the Jeopardy theme. Are you serious? Why does it take so long? There's no way. Really? If this doesn't load, I am probably going to just say screw it and end the video and then upload another video of me reacting to the end. But obviously I gotta use my Xbox because this isn't even loading YouTube. It's pathetic. Hello? Well, this thing sucks. Let me give this one more try. He was just shooting his own guy. I don't have enough ammo for this. Wow, I actually got past that part. Problem is, if I don't think it can save here. If I get wrecked again, I have to do this again. This whole thing has spoiled the ending for me. Like, it's ruined it. Oh, are you kidding me? Okay, thank God. Wait. No, never mind. I was like, I have to do all that again? This is really a terrible boss. I mean, the game's like not technically over yet, but I can already say that this game is nowhere close to being as good as Tomb Raider 2013. Maybe the next two are much better, but like this is average. Like the story is average, the characters are basically like cliches. Ah! Come on. No! Why, Nathan? Why don't you roll when I tell you to roll? This cover system on this 15-year-old game is garbage. It's unacceptable. Gears of War came out a year before this, and it's way better than this. God. Go F yourself. Oh man, the title of this video is just gonna be the ending of Uncharted is rage inducing. Are you I'm about ready to start busting out the sensor sound. Come on! I have to get up and aim because blind fire sucks. What? This video is going to have, I'm going to have to edit, well, I mean, I'm not going to edit anything out, but I'm going to put at the beginning of the video is just a montage of me raging at this piece of crap final boss. What a piece of crap. Is this like, does it have a notoriously bad final boss? Is this like just me, or is it basically common knowledge that it has a bad ending? Is that the like general consensus? Or am I just crazy and I'm tired? I don't have any ammo, what do you want me to do? This is so stupid. You don't give me enough ammo, you give me terrible cover system, the box breaks, and he's a one shot from him kills me. And I pop my head out for a second, I'm dead. Terrible design. Seems like it's just made to punish you. God, please give me a checkpoint, for the love of God. I have 2 rounds. Please, just be a final cutscene. Just end this misery. Oh my god! Wait, am I gonna fist fight him? No, seriously, what am I? Thank you. What? You literally have like a split second. This is so dumb. It's also dumb because, like, this guy, if this was a real scenario, would just come up and shoot me. Oh my god, what, who designed this? Take his gun! God! What a lame final boss. And terribly designed, too. Charted! Easy.
Elena! Oh, God.
Elena. That just, like... having any that pisses me off, like... No pun intended, sullies the experience for me. What? Something tells me this comes into play again at some point.
Sorry you didn't get your story.
That's all right. There'll be other stories. You still owe me one.
So Drake's fortune refers to Sir Francis Drake, doesn't it? Amy Hennig, Bruce Straley, both of them are gone now, so, yeah, that's Uncharted 1, so, oh, and I'm sorry, I keep doing that thing with my leg, and it probably picks up on the mic, I mean, I don't know what I expected, I didn't expect, like, some kind of masterpiece, but I hear that 2 is, so, this was, like, their first crack at Uncharted, so maybe it gets better, but, like, I was not, like, my socks weren't blown out. I mean, it felt like a standard third-person action-adventure game, but with, like, really good animation for the time, and, the graphics were fine. I mean, it's a remastered, but, some of the puzzles were good, the few that they did have. The combat got a little tedious after a while. Floaty combat, because it's an old game. The cover system was garbage. Didn't work half the time. That final boss was garbage. The story was like... not much to it, really. But I have the feeling it's going to get more complex and interesting in the next one, so I'm actually looking forward to the second one more than I was for this one. I can't believe I finished this in sort of one sitting, like six parts. I just blasted through it. Wasn't going to originally, because like when I did my Mass Effect recordings, I did at most, like at the very most, four in one day, so 4 hours. I just did this in 6 hours. Why? Why did I do that to myself? Two, I'm not going to go through it as quick. Yeah, Blue Point Games. There you go. That was my first playthrough of Uncharted Drake's Fortune. And I'm debating whether or not I should go right into Uncharted 2 after this, or if I should bounce back and forth between that and God of War. Because I want to play the God of War games too, but will I burn myself out on Uncharted if I play them all in a row, or what? I don't know. But yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to... Hey, Phil Harrison. Oh, he's gone now. But, Shuhei Yoshida, I think he's gone too. I don't know if it's a game I'd replay. Maybe I'd watch the cutscenes. Like, I don't know if it has much replay value. I don't care about trophies, so I'm not going to go back and collect all 60 collectibles. But, yeah, I mean, that's really all I have for this playthrough. So, I'll have to make a playlist now for the Uncharted games like I did for Mass Effect. So, thank you for watching my six-part series of me playing Uncharted 1, Drake's Fortune. I hope to see you for Uncharted 2. But until then, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.